trying to fill the void of not knowing God, I basically picked up girls, picked up money, picked up drugs, whatever I could put in that hole that was in my heart instead of God. By 22, I already had a six-year-old, and then I had an eight-month-old with another lady. So I tried to pull my life together thinking that I could possibly start a family with her, get things together, work a 9-to-5, and sell drugs, but still missing that void in my heart of God not being there. I basically filled it in with drugs, with heroin, with ecstasy, with Percocets, and started my day off every day with some kind of drug in my system. At work one day, it was a phone call I got that my son's mom got locked up. My son had to go to DFS, stay with her mom more, like. So running crazy, just not knowing, thinking that my life was completely over. Everything that I built up to put into this household that I called a family, we weren't married, you know, stuff like that. And then all of it just falling apart within one day of me being at work. I mean, my son's mom being locked up was like a big thing for me because it was, she was my everything at the time. I probably snorted 22 pills that day in less than like 5 hours. With the same breath that I snorted a pill with, I cried out. I was like, God, can you help me? Can you help me? And it, within that time, I didn't know that he heard me. I didn't know that he heard me, so I kept doing. The guy that snitched on her got out. We beat him up. Then next Sunday, I called my older son's mom and asked her. I mean, I called her during the week and asked her, hey, show me who Christ is. And when she brought me to the church, they prayed with me. I finally just surrendered my life to Christ and just gave it my all. Now, I mean, I'm a single dad with both of my kids, very strong walking with that. I don't have a girlfriend. I don't long for a girlfriend. If God wants to give me one, then that's fine, which that was a big thing that I put in my heart was girls. So he delivered me from that, delivered me from the drugs. Deliver me from all my anger issues, and he's filled that void. And I mean, now I'm restoring windows. That's a lot of carpentry work in between that. That's something I always liked to do when I was younger. He uses me in the church on almost an every week basis in some type of way, whether it's kids, mind ministry, poetry, even just taking up offering. I feel honored to be able to serve the Lord. The thing I like about Harvest Church is, well, I mean, if you look at me myself, I got tattoos. I'm able to be myself. I don't have to dress a certain way. I don't have to be a certain way, act a certain way. We walk on with our own relationship here. Our relationship with God, it's awesome. It's not based on religion. We're a bunch of imperfect people searching for a perfect God.